It has been a bit of a week. Well, we're finally at part three, but this is actually part two of the 24-gallon reef tank. So if you missed part one, which was the whole five-year history of that tank, just find the link below. And this is part two. We're gonna go into all the equipment and all the livestock, so you don't wanna miss it. If you would be so kind, consider liking this video and subscribing to Marine Depot and My First Fish Tank. And without further ado, here's part three.
First up, we got an upgrade to our lights. Now we're running the Reef Breeder Photon V2 Plus. That is the exact same Ecotec MP10. I've had to replace the wet side once just because I broke it. Okay, you ready to see my custom egg crate caddy? Okay, look what I'm running in here. Oh my goodness, that's it. Look at how nasty that is. Hey, but it works well. I'm using a super bright water sponge on the top, and then I currently have a small, tiny, teeny bag of activated carbon. My always go-to heaters. I have two Eheim Jaegers. I have a Reef Breeder EXO auto top-off unit. Works fantastic. Using down here, if you can see, I'm using the same Cobalt MJ1200 I've used for a couple years now. The Fluval M60 comes with this really nice looking stand, and here's what I keep down below. You ready for it? It's not very exciting. I have used the Sterilite file cabinet holder. I've used this for 2 years now. This is my auto top off reservoir. Fantastic. I'm using two of these trip lights, which I've used for years. I'm finally upgrading to Wi-Fi outlets, but I really like these trip light outlets because they're individually controlled, so you can just flip them on and off, which is awesome. I always recommend every beginner, every person to buy one of these Bayite temperature controllers. They're my go-to. This is the 10 amp version. It costs like 30 bucks. And then lastly, underneath, so you got display tank, cabinet, and then down here, I have the Simplicity reservoir. It's awesome. I have calcium over here, I think, and alkalinity over here. And then I'm using, these are the Komor X1. These are Bluetooth, so you have to be close by. Quite good. So let's move on to the problems. I'm not having a whole lot of problems with this tank, but I am having some minor algae growth. And that's probably because we just saw the nitrate level are a bit high. What would you recommend for getting on top of that? Maybe add some hermit crabs before it gets out of control. Another problem is just little pockets here and there. Diatoms, also some dinos, and then cyano in certain little pockets.
Let's jump right in with the livestock. Let's start with the fish first, a shrimp goby and a pistol shrimp. They both live underneath this rock. I actually had to raise up this rock because there was really no good habitat for them. I put a few pieces of rubble rock below it, added some sand to make it a deeper sand bed, and they're loving it. PJ Cardinals. I had those PJ Cardinals when I did the Encore build, and I needed to rehome them. So I went ahead and moved the two pajama cardinals over to this tank, and they love it. No aggression issues between the clownfish attacking them. They seem to get along really well. They acclimated super quick, and they're a really good addition to the tank. And then we have two clownfish. We have the larger female, which is a true percula clownfish, and then we have the Ocellaris. I guess it's called a snowstorm. I don't really keep up with all the names, but it's the all white small male. All right, moving on to inverts. Not corals, but all the other inverts. We have a blood red fire shrimp. I paid like $55 for that thing. The prices on those and even Hawaiian skunk cleaners is crazy right now. And I almost never see him. He literally lives behind the bubble coral right there. He almost never ever comes out. But anyway, he adds a nice splash of red. I have a ton of amphipods. Some of these amphipods can be like a quarter of an inch. They are huge. I bought a conch over a year ago now, and the sand bed wasn't very deep until recently when I added the pistol shrimp. So I added that sand bed, and the conch has just loved burying himself or herself into the sand bed and just makes the rounds, keeps the sand bed super aerated, which is awesome to see. I have a whole bunch of snails in there, some Nassaria snails, Cerith snails, and then some Mexican turbo snails, maybe an Astrea snail or two, and might even have a couple of Trochus snails in there. They've gotten huge. The ones that have survived in there have gotten huge. They do a really good job of keeping the film algae off, so I think I have the optimal amount of snails right now, but I do still need some cleanup crew member to kind of battle some of the nuisance algae that's starting to grow. Moving on to the other inverts, the corals. Here's what the tank looked like when it started out. I'm going to show you some videos and some pictures here. You know, when we started out with nothing in it, when we added our first euphelia, you know, with the anemones, as the anemones grew and multiplied and then died off. But you can just see there's some huge growth, especially amongst the leather coral, the acan colonies. Let's just go individually, coral by coral, and see how they're doing. So the first one, we're gonna look at the wall frog spawn. This is one coral that really hasn't grown very much. I'm not sure if it's its placement, I'm not sure if it's the water parameters, I'm not sure if it's the lighting issues, but when it first arrived, the polyps extended so much more, as you can see in this video from the quarantine tank. It was much more full. And I've noticed, probably 6 months ago, some recession. Well, you know, usually you can see that little white rim in between the polyps and the stony base. And the white rim used to be like that big, and then it shrunk and shrunk and shrunk until it was nothing. That white line of growth has started to reappear. So it's starting to grow again, which I love seeing. Now we got a green encrusting SPS. If you know the name, why don't you tell me what that name is? I got this little frag from a friend of mine, Dave, at Aquarium Works. I think he gave it to me. It was like that big. It was tiny. And I'm like, oh, whatever. It's SPS. I don't really do SPS. I'll glue it on the back. And oh my goodness, look at this. It is now the size of my palm. And just encrusting, it's gonna cover that whole coral. So whatever's happening in there, this encrusting green SPS is doing very well. Then we got the toadstool. Now the toadstool, when I got it from a buddy of mine, it was a small piece. And now this piece you're looking at now looks even smaller, but that's because I've actually fragged it into two pieces. So I actually have one larger piece in my quarantine tank, and then I have this smaller piece in here. Then we got the finger leather. Check out these pictures, before and after. I don't even remember how small it was, but it was tiny. It was a small little leather coral. And now look at it, it's huge. It's almost two-thirds of the way up my tank, and I'm probably gonna have to frag some of it soon because it's just gonna end up taking over everything. But it's a beautiful piece. I love having it in the middle. Not the most colorful, but really adds so much good movement to the tank. Then the acan. This one's amazing. Even though I'm not always the best with certain corals, for some reason acans love me. I don't know what it is. I got this piece when it had two heads, maybe a third little bud starting. The last time I counted, I got to 30 and I couldn't count the rest. There are over 30 heads now and it is ginormous. I love acan. Acans might be my second favorite or my first favorite coral. Then we have two hammer corals. Even though it's broken up to a few pieces, one of the hammer corals I had to frag off a while ago because the peppermint shrimp almost killed one of the heads. So I fragged that head off, put it into a quarantine tank, and it's finally grown back. But look at this growth. It's really big on all of these hammer corals. So the growth is huge. And not only that, these corals, they almost look like bubble coral because the polyps have puffed up so much. They get huge and they seem super happy and they're growing at a really fast rate. So I'm happy with them as well. And then lastly, I think we got the bubble coral doing okay. I think it had some flow issues. I've moved it to a couple places. You can see when I first got this bubble coral, it was super puffed out and it's receded a little bit from the base. Actually, it's receded quite a bit from the base and it's receded on the edge where the current goes by it and is pushing it towards the MP10. So I'm watching that. I may end up having to move it again or move it to another tank. It's still quite full, but there has been some of that recession and I haven't really seen much, if any, growth of this in the last year or so. So what does the future hold for the Fluval M60 mixed reef tank? Well, fish-wise, nothing. I don't think I'm gonna add any fish. Everybody seems super happy in there right now and I don't really wanna disturb it. Coral-wise, I am gonna add a couple more corals because there's a couple spots over here, just on this rock over here above the acans and then over back here next to this green SPS coral. I am having some issues with some nuisance algae. And what would you guys recommend? I've never had a whole lot of success with like Mexican turbo snails. Maybe add some hermit crabs. It's definitely too small for any sort of tang. And then lastly, I am eventually going to completely break down this system. I don't know when that's gonna happen. And the reason I'm gonna break it down is it's been around for a while. Some of the seams are starting not to give way, but it looks like the seams might give at some point. So I wanna get a slightly larger tank, maybe a 40 gallon tank, and get a peninsula tank and just put it right here, move all of this over and then add to the aquascape so I can add quite a bit more. It's our new puppy, by the way. It's just Theodosia. She's a sweetheart. She's a Japanese chin. Oh, don't growl at me. Are you growling at me? Okay, I'll put you down. All right. All right, so we've finished the Fluval M60 reef tank and we've also done the 40 gallon breeder tank. So that means the only system we have left is the Lux 90, and you don't wanna miss the final episode in all my tanks because we are gonna be adding the clownfish to the clownfish harem tank. So it should be super exciting. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to Marine Depot and My First Fish Tank. And as always, happy reefing. We'll see you next time. Be well, everybody.